Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today we'll be reading The Holy Order, which I found here in the Mayor's House in Rivervale. The Holy Order, it protects and reigns from the beginning of time until the present day, adamant and unbreakable. At its apex stands the sacred lightborn Malthus. All along the Order has been the driving force of Enderal in political as well as religious regard. Its roots go back to the opening of the land, when Vin was still young and the bygone sea was still blue and pure. The eye in which the snake resides is watching over everything and everyone. Its keepers in red, its arcanists in white clad, are carrying its doctrines into the world. Being the highest institution in Enderal, the eternal, clear principles of the path lay to its feet, allocating its members a steady spot below the beneficent cloak of Malthus. Directly under the divine Malthus is the post of the Grand Master, owning the military decisional power of Enderal's troops. His area of access ranges over outposts across several continents. He too is revered, albeit not to such a high degree as Malthus in his divinity. With the post of the Seneschal, his deputy and placeholder, the Grand Master forms the fourth and highest signet of the Order. Below this pinnacle of power follows the third signet, where the hierarchy splits into two branches, the military and the arcane, represented by the signet leader and the archmagister. A new member of the Order starts his career as a novice. Generally only pure-blooded Andralians, often nobles, can be approved for an entrance examination as novice, and in the subsequent years they have to prove themselves in a novitiate to be allowed to ascend into the first signet. In exceptions, examinees that qualify through particular talents are acquainted with the Order. Being such a chosen one, it is not easy to shine among the novices with high reputation, but some cases prove that also these ones can come a long way. Every year an examination takes place, which puts the mind's strength under a hectic trial. Only the most talented novices are entitled to participate and match against each other, which is why some have to wait a very long time for this opportunity. Out of the novitiate outgrows the first signet. The army and the town watch are tightly interwoven into the hierarchy of the Order. Bannermasters in the second signet on the military path and commandments, sorry, commandants of the army, stand on the same executional tier. Through this, it is ensured that full control over the troops is maintained within the Order. The clergy, impersonated by the High Priest, by all means has influence in the Order, but is not incorporated into its organization. Like the troops, he is subordinate to the mighty circle of influence of the power of the Order as central organ and keeper of right, faith, and regulation in Enderal. Legal verdicts are rendered in the tribunal, an entity belonging to the Order that consists out of 13 ambassadors of the populace. It is to be elected every 5 years from all layers of society. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, The Holy Order.